Welcome to the second step of solving the V-cube 3. In this step, we will solve the entire first layer of the cube, which means that we will go from this into this. If you followed our previous guides, then by now you should have created a cross consisting of four black edges that match with both centers adjacent to them. If not, please make sure to watch our previous videos to get there. Let's begin. In this step, we will solve the black corners. As we said, every corner has a unique position. To find this position, we have to look at the colors of the corner. For example, this one has black, blue, and red. This is the blue side, because it has the blue center. This is the red side, and this is the black side. Those three sides have only one piece in common, which means that this corner has to go to this exact position. To solve these corners more easily, we need a new weapon. Let's check it out. It's our first small algorithm. It's just a sequence of four moves. Please follow along. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Let's do it again sometimes to get the hang of it. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Again, R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Again, R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Just two more times, but from now and on, let's use our index fingers to turn the top side to increase our efficiency. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. And finally, R, U, R inverted, U inverted. As you can see, my cube got solved, while yours is probably still messed up. This has to do with the algorithm itself. If you perform these four moves 6 times in a row, then they restore the cube back to its starting position. I started with my cube solved, but you, on the other hand, had only the cross solved correctly, which means that if your cross is still in its place, then there is a good chance that you didn't mess up the algorithm. Now, we also have to examine the mirror algorithm executed with our left hand. It goes like this. L inverted, U inverted, L, U. Great! Now let's use them to finish with the first layer. To tell them apart, we will call them the righty and the lefty algorithm, but you can clearly see that they are the same algorithm, just mirrored. Anyway, let's get back to the solution. First, try to find a black corner on the top side, like this one. Remember to keep the yellow side on top. Once you find a black corner, place it above its correct position by turning the yellow side. To make sure that the position is correct, look at the other two colors of the corner to see if they match with the adjacent centers. For example, this corner has black, of course, and then green and red. This is the green center and this is the red center. Therefore, we are good to go. Hold the cube so that the corner is on the front and perform the algorithm. If it's on the right, do the righty. If it's on the left, do the lefty. You might have to do this up to 5 times. So every time you perform the algorithm, you have to check if you solved the corner. Let's begin. My corner is on the right, so I'll do the righty move. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. And as you can see, the corner is now solved. Let's try another one, like this one. This one has black, blue, and red. Keep a finger on that piece so as not to lose track of it and find its correct position. Here is the red center and here is the blue one. So the corner goes here. Place it above its correct position by turning the top layer. Hold the cube, as we said, with the corner in the front. This time, the corner is on the left, so we will do the lefty. This time, we will have to do it 3 times in total. Let's begin. L inverted, U inverted, L, U. As you can see, the corner is in the correct position, but it's not oriented correctly. Every second time you perform the algorithm, the corner will twist once in the same position. Let's continue. L inverted, U inverted, L, U. It's not solved, so we must continue. L inverted, U inverted, L, U. And as you can see, the corner is now solved. One weird position you might find yourself in is when there is no black corner on the top side. Yet the black layer is definitely not solved. This means that some corners might be trapped on a different position on the black side. Thankfully, this is really easy to fix. All you need to do is to find a different corner on the top side and use it to kick the trapped one out. Once you do it, you can insert the black corner correctly. Also note that if a corner is trapped on the black side, it might be hard to identify it. For example, this corner seems just fine. But if we take a closer look, we can see that this corner has black, orange, and green. Yet these two centers are not the green and orange. Having all those in mind, let's finish our first layer. To kick this corner out of the black side, we need to use another corner, like this one. Let's do it. It's on the right, so we will do the righty move. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Now the corner is free, which means that we can place it above its correct position, which is this one. Because this corner has green and orange and those two are the green and orange centers, and solve it normally. The corner is on the left and its correct position is right there. So we will do the lefty. L inverted, U inverted, L, U. As you can see, it only required one repetition to solve it. The next one is this one, which has orange and blue. Just like these two centers, which means that it should go in this position. This time, we have to do the algorithm 5 times to solve the corner. If it takes more than 5 times, it means that you have done something wrong. Let's begin. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. The corner is not solved, but every time we have to check. Again, R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Not solved. Again, R, U, R inverted, U inverted. Not solved yet. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. This was our 4th repetition, which means that at most it will require one more. Let's do it. R, U, R inverted, U inverted. And as you can see, we just finished the first layer. If you find it hard, check out our example solve to demystify any misunderstanding. See you in the next step. Good luck!